of hurricane season, which also happens to be the day Irma made landfall in Florida 4 years ago.
Climate change is helping to fuel these storms, making them stronger and costlier than ever before. Storms in 2021 have already caused $52 billion in damage, making this the fifth costliest season on record. 2017, the year of Irma, is number one at $294 billion worth of damage. This year, we've had three major storms so far. That's Category 3 or higher, Grace, Ida, and Larry, and there are still 3 months to go.
Right now, the Saffir-Simpson scale only goes to Category 5, 157-mile-an-hour winds and higher. As NBC2 First Alert meteorologist Lauren Hope found out, these storms are getting so strong, we may actually need a Category 6. And it all starts right here in Southwest Florida.
Florida has taken on more direct hits from hurricanes than any other state. When you live in a state that's particularly vulnerable to tropical impacts, you may wonder how climate change will impact future hurricane seasons.
I'm obviously really concerned.
Dr. Moeller is an associate professor at the Water School at Florida Gulf Coast University. Her research focuses on past hurricane activity through digging holes in the ground and studying the sediment cores.
This allows us to extend the hurricane record back.
Right now, the National Hurricane Center's database only goes back roughly 150 years. Dr. Moeller's work can fill in the data gaps from the past to more accurately predict what future trends will be. Dr. Moeller says climate change will lead to a longer hurricane season.
We're getting early season hurricanes and then late season hurricanes as well.
This year was the seventh year in a row that the Atlantic hurricane season started early, and it was the earliest on record we got to an E-named storm.
Also, we're seeing a slowing down of the forward speed of storms because the upper level winds are actually slowing down, which is due to climate change.
This could lead to storms generating more storm surge, rainfall, and damage. According to the Environmental Protection Agency, the average global sea surface temperature is warming. Warm water is fuel for tropical systems, so a warming trend means stronger storms.
In the geologic past, when sea surface temperatures are warmer, we see more landfalling hurricanes in Southwest Florida.
It's unclear if climate change will lead to an increase in the number of named storms. Now, what is clear is that climate change will lead to the intensity of these storms. The proportion of Category 4 and 5 hurricanes has already increased due to warming sea surface temperatures. And in the future, hurricanes may be able to intensify even more quickly.
The frequency of 4s and 5s is just increasing through time. So it's not going to surprise me if we end up having to create a Category 6.
Dr. Everham, an associate professor at the Water School at FGCU, says Southwest Florida is already experiencing the impacts of climate change.
We can pretend it's not happening, or we can figure out how we're going to respond to that reality. And as a citizen of Southwest Florida, I would very much rather that we responded to it.
We're seeing these really intense storms now every season. And so people that are living in Florida and want to stay living in Florida, it's more important for us, I think, than many other states. We are at the front line. We are seeing the effects of climate change already.
Count on the NBC2 Hurricane Tracking Team to keep you informed throughout hurricane season and how climate change will impact seasons to come. At Fort Myers Beach, Lauren Hope, NBC2.